Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. My name is Yana, this is The Scented. We're really projecting Peggy Bundy vibes today, but I'm kind of digging it. I got the shirt on Shein and I'm like low-key obsessed. But anyway, today's video is the ultimate do not buy list. So these are the fragrances that I just completely don't recommend that you guys buy for various reasons. They're not all bad fragrances. I'll explain why each of these is on the do not buy list. So if that sounds interesting to you, then just keep on watching and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Whether you're new or you've been watching for a while and you just haven't given me the sub yet, just give me the sub. We do all the fun fragrance things together. I let you know the good, I let you know the bad. So just give a little back to me, okay? Now let's get into the ultimate do not buy list. A few of these I have and I'll explain to you why they're somewhat regrettable. We're gonna start with the new release from Guerlain, and this is Mon Guerlain Sparkling Bouquet. This one I was so excited about. The moment that I saw it on Fragrance Buy, I bought it. It's a nice scent, and I told you guys in a haul when I received it that it's a really nice scent. The problem with it is that it has almost no longevity. Like, it almost is like gone within a couple hours. I have to keep respraying this. It doesn't bring a lot of anything new or unique to the table. It's an unnecessary flanker, and I do believe that it will end up getting discontinued. It's just not unique enough. There's a lot of other nice flower bomb. Oh, did I say flower bomb? Mon Guerlain. There are a lot of really nice Mon Guerlain flankers that are still available. Bloom of Rose is my favorite one. You guys know, even the Floral, that one's really, really nice. The Eau de Toilette was very long lasting for an Eau de Toilette. I think it's discontinued, but it's still available. This one's the newest one, but unfortunately, like, it's just a fruitier, lighter, more girly, and less of that Mon Guerlain vanilla and lavender DNA. It's more like pear, it's more bubbly, it's really simplified, made into a more mainstream fragrance. A lot of the uniqueness has been taken out and the performance has been basically removed. So for that reason mainly, is because of how poor the performance is, I will put this on the do not buy list. If you want a Mon Guerlain, please just go for the original or go for the Bloom of Rose. Those will not disappoint. The next one on the do not buy list is the brand new release from Dior, and it is the new Miss Dior 2021 Eau de Parfum. That one is such a disappointment. I had sprayed it on my skin. It's very, very poor longevity. It's gone, like in the blink of an eye, it's gone. It's watered down. It doesn't have the same character as the previous Miss Dior versions had, so just go for any other Miss Dior. Stay away from the 2021. It is a huge disappointment. It's not worth the money. Like, buying at retail, buying at full price is definitely not worth it. It's a severely watered down, kind of musty, characterless floral fragrance. It's not unique. The previous Miss Diors were way, way better. So that is on the do not buy list. Next is La Vie Belle. La Vie Belle is just already way, way overdone. Everybody has it, everybody wears it. Unless you absolutely are in love with this DNA and you need to have it in your life, there is no need. Like, it's time to move away from that. It's becoming a redundant scent profile. I have the L'Eclat Eau de Toilette. That one as well, it's a nice scent, but it's not for me. I understand that's my personal opinion, it's not for me, but just the original La Vie Belle, it's no longer necessary. We're moving away from that. And if you're just getting into fragrances now, there is no need for you to visit that fragrance. There's no need. Next is Viva La Juicy, all the flankers, everything to do with Viva La Juicy. I understand if you love Viva La Juicy, that's fine, to each their own. You can wear Viva La Juicy, by all means, enjoy it. Enjoy it to your little heart's desire. You can go for the Viva La Juicy, even the Gold Couture, not bad. But then you have Le Bubbly, Le Bubblicious, Le Noir, Le everything else. Don't bother with those. Don't even look in their direction. Tunnel vision, only Viva La Juicy or Gold Couture. Don't even worry about the rest of them. They're not important, they're irrelevant. I tried that new Le Bubbly or whatever. Oh my God, it has a very synthetic, rubbery note. I didn't smell that in the original Viva La Juicy, which I used to love. They just keep getting ruined with every new release. So you don't need to worry about all of the flankers of Viva La Juicy. Just stick to the OG or the Gold Couture if you really must. If you really must. If you don't must, then don't buy it. Don't buy Viva La Juicy at all. We're gonna move on. Don't worry about Coco Mademoiselle L'Eau Privée. Coco Mademoiselle is one of my favorite fragrances from Chanel, but the L'Eau Privée night fragrance is as well a watered down, simplified, and really not long lasting fragrance, especially for the price point. Guys, you are going to get an hour at most out of this. It is almost non-existent. Do you want to pay $100 and something and not even smell yourself? If the answer to that is yes, then buy this. But for me, like, I'm telling you guys, I'm looking out for you. You don't need this. You don't need this. You can get the original Coco Mademoiselle and just spray less. If it's too much for you, just do a half spray. This one's like, it's completely redundant. You don't need this. Poor longevity. I understand it's supposed to be the fragrance for going to sleep and you want to be a little bit luxe and bougie and wear your Coco Mademoiselle to bed, and that's what it's made for. Really, if you don't have anything else to spend your money on, then yes. But otherwise, no. You guys probably see a common theme here. It's either redundancy or very, very poor performance. So that's all really that we're sticking to here. Like, either a fragrance is completely redundant and you don't need it anymore, or the performance for the price point is horrendous. And the next one is no different, and I only have a little mini bottle, and it is Flower Bomb Dew. I love the way that this smells, but if you're gonna pay full retail and you're going to Sephora and you're buying this, even at the VIB sale, even if you're getting 20% off, you have to douse yourself in this. It's a beautiful scent. It's nice, like the name suggests, dewy, soft, musky, really, really lovely fragrance. I actually really love how this smells. I got this at Sephora, and I don't know if you guys can see, but you can see the line of where I've worn it. That was two wearings. That was me wearing it twice. And both times I was like, where is it? Where is it? It's not here. It's not on my skin. Where did it go? This is such a ghost. It's so beautiful at first, for the first 10 minutes. And then, like, you turn away and then it disappears. It just sneaks off on you. It's gone and you're never getting it back. You're gonna have to wear the whole thing on one wearing for it to be worthwhile. So, like, retail is like $180. I'm talking Canadian dollars. Really not worth it for the price point. Beautiful, beautiful scent. Painful, painful longevity. Okay, the next one, this is the one that you should buy, and this is the Gabrielle Essence from Chanel. Don't bother with the original Gabrielle. This is one of those rare times where the flanker that came out after is like significantly better. The Gabrielle Essence is a stunner. It's a stunning, like, Chanel version of J'adore from Dior. That's basically what this is. The original Gabrielle, simply not as good. Simply not as good. Something about it just rubbed me the wrong way, and I find this composition and this scent profile a lot better. Just way, way better. So really, I would suggest you go for the Essence versus the original Gabrielle. And then we're gonna touch very, very quickly on three men's fragrances. You guys probably already know. Pause the video, make your guesses in the description. Let me know what you think the men's fragrances that I'm putting on the do not buy list are. Okay, and now come back. So the first one is Sauvage. Guys, please, can we be done with Sauvage? Can this be no more? Like, I don't know if you ladies are with me, but I am so over Sauvage. Like, I don't want to smell it one more time. The new Elixir came out. That one's not bad. But can we go away from just that scent profile? Like, at least let's tone it down. At least if you guys are gonna buy it, let's buy less of it. It's like, you can't name every kid that's born Mike. Like, we have too many Mikes already. Can we have less Mikes? Same thing with Sauvage. There's too many. There's too many of you guys wearing Sauvage. There's just way too many of you. And Aventus is in the same boat. Aventus, there's too many of you. I know you guys think that you're like really bougie and you're wearing Aventus and it's Creed and it's all the rage and it's hot. No more, please. There are way too many dupes of Aventus. There are way too many Aventus wearers. It's no longer interesting. I'm sure a lot of you guys feel the same way about Baccarat Rouge, and honestly, I'm basically over Baccarat Rouge for that exact reason. It's a beautiful fragrance, but it's overdone now. Like, it's severely overdone. So anyway, I'm not putting Baccarat Rouge on the list yet, but it's maybe gonna be on next year's list. And lastly, if you guys haven't left yet, let me push some buttons right now. 1 million. 1 million is absolutely horrendous. It is just the worst fragrance. It is the ultimate douchebag scent. And I just really, like, if you really want to identify yourself as a douchey guy, that's what you're doing with 1 million. Nobody cares that it's in a gold bar. Nobody likes it. Okay, I'm gonna say 23 plus. At most 25. If you're a late bloomer and you're slow to mature and you're a guy, 25 plus, you have no business wearing 1 million. So that's on the do not buy if you're over 25. And that is it. I probably offended some of you, but please know that these are my opinions only. I am not the authority in telling you guys what to wear. I'm just somebody who knows a lot about fragrance and I'm sharing my knowledge. You wear what you want and enjoy it. Enjoy it for yourself. Nobody will arrest you. But if you care about a fragrance critic's opinion, which is what I'm sure most of you guys are here for, then you have that. But take it and run with it and do what you wish with this information. I'm not gonna come after you. I'm not gonna arrest you. There's no fragrance police that's gonna stop you from wearing these fragrances. These are just my suggestions. Take them as such. Okay, we're done here for today. I'm getting worked up because I know a lot of you guys are going to come after me, especially the 1 million wearing dudes, because they have a lot to say most of the time. Anyway, that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you found this helpful. As always, take negative videos with a grain of salt. Do you, and enjoy your fragrance, whatever it may be. If you guys enjoyed, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. It helps my algorithm just as much. Subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!